people, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, today I'm going to talk about this whole scandal surrounding Shaggy and the big $100 million that some people were acting like it went missing. Now, here's the thing, people. When Shaggy handed over that big symbolic $100 million check to the Bustamante Hospital for Children, I remember saying to my brethren, I hope they make it clear to the people that they're not literally handing over $100 million, right? And at the time, when I was sifting through and reading the fine details, I could see that it wasn't a case of here is $100 million, right? But you had to actually read the articles and read the post and listen to the various press releases that were coming out at the time. But let's be realistic. A lot of people, especially in 2019, they don't read news. They look at the headlines. They look at the main picture and the story. And then run with that. So when people say Shaggy with this $100 million check, you know, handing it over, right? They're thinking, oh, well, Shaggy gave Bustamante the $100 million. Right, so when down the road they're hearing that, oh, the money still hasn't been handed over, people immediately jump on the, oh, well, Shaggy thief it. People, this is what I don't like. First of all, most of the people who were bawling, say, Shaggy thief $100 million, them never go to concert. Them never put $1 to one ticket. But yet still, they are the most vocal ones, right? They were acting like somebody thief something for them. Like Shaggy, like then give Shaggy something to put on and him thief it. People, I understand that the culture we live in and the country where we live in, I understand that we're used to getting robbed and tricked and scammed. I get it. People are skeptical. I get it, right? But you have to understand, the reason why a politician can move and cipher off certain funds is because the public don't even know about those funds in the first place. We don't have full transparency. The Shaggy concert was this big public thing. Everybody heard the amount that was made. So it wouldn't even be possible for Shaggy to just thief the money and go out in business and nobody know, because at some point, obviously, Bustamante will say, yo, we didn't get the money. And let me tell you something, people. This situation was not handled properly by a number of sides. It wasn't handled properly by Bustamante, right? Bustamante them should have come out and said, listen, this is why the money hasn't come over yet. And people, we were not actually expecting the raw cash. We were going to get some equipment. They were going to buy the equipment and give it to us, right? The press, the media, the way they reported it, because I remember seeing the story when it first popped up back again, they made it sound as if the money gone missing, right? The headlines that were reported made it sound like the money gone missing, like nobody can't find the money. It's been 2 years and Bustamante still can't account for it. The media played a role in stirring up the population, and the media know how Jamaican people stay, right? They know our headlines sell papers. Them know most people now read and go down the nitty-gritty of things. And also, the Shaggy Foundation should have also done more to educate the public, right? But this is what I want Shaggy to realize, and I want the people of Jamaica to realize. You need to live in the world that exists and not the one that you want to exist. Okay? The world that we exist in, the culture that we exist in, is obsessed with negativity. When people hear something bad, they automatically accept it as gospel. Right? When people hear say, yo, you know, you say Shaggy TV 100 million. What? Yeah, man, me didn't know something more than something, man. Yeah, man, me didn't know. Next thing you know, all kind of people that message me and tell me, say, Shaggy thief me money. I'm like, what? How that will make sense? The story, there must be an explanation behind all this. People couldn't wait for throw Shaggy under the bus. Just last year, he was the golden boy. That's how people are. When I saw people showering Shaggy with praise and saying, oh, Shaggy are the real big man, I'm like, let's give them some time. Let's give them some time. They'll find something to hate you for. That's the culture we have, people. That is the culture we have. Right? You can give somebody. Let's be realistic now about the culture we have. And people can say, well, it's the same thing in our so-and-so. I'm talking about Jamaica with me born and grow. Let's talk about our culture. You can give somebody. Somebody can beg you something and you give it to them 999 times. And on the 1,000th occasion, you said, you know, so I can't deal with that right now. You have to go check me another time. You're wicked. You're wicked and you're dead and you're mean. Right? All the other good times, all the other times you said yes, are immediately forgotten. People can't wait to find a reason to throw you under the bus. People can't wait to find a reason to hate you. Right? So I don't know if Shaggy is surprised at this. Right? Because if he's really a part of the culture, that him should I at least kind of see this coming, right? When I heard Shaggy talking about this thing at this press conference, he sounded very emotional. He sounded like he was hurt, and he would be, because when people are calling up a name next to things like this, making it sound like, boy, oh, you tricked the people and might run off for the money, you would be hurt, right? So now we're getting to hear that. Of course, as I said before, the original plan was to buy the equipment, the items, and hand them over. But now we're hearing they're actually going to expand the ICU, right? That's the intensive care unit, right? They're going to add on another building, right? And the foundation is now going to hand over that $100 million for the construction of that building and to equip the extra ward that is going to be built, right? Now, again, when I read the article on Loop, the things I just mentioned a while ago, they are in the last two paragraphs. You see how far them buried, that is buried way down at the bottom. So you know, so enough people don't even know what I read so far. Right? Right? And for some people, you can't convince them to shag in a teeth the money. That's just how people are. You can't tell me nothing, you must teeth something out of it. Because a lot of people know, well, them would never have an account with $100 million for charity and a thief something out of it. So, because them know I saw them stay, they try to project that onto other people. Right? So, I hope Shaggy take this as a learning lesson. I hope he doesn't become demotivated. Right? I hope him don't kiss him teeth and say, yo, forget about this, because at the end of the day, children at Bustamante benefit from this. Right? And even though the way how it all play out, you know, it kind of put a down on the situation. And as a human being, you're going to think to yourself, yo, man, I can't buy this time, man. This is not worth it. I know that's what I would probably say. After a couple of days, I might change my mind. But knowing how me stay, if I'm Shaggy in this situation, me, I kiss my teeth and say, I can't bother. Right? I might change my mind the next week. But in the moment, that's what I would say. Right? But people, we need to do better. We need to do better than this, right? And don't get me confused or twisted. People, especially those who went to the concert and the sponsors, do have a right to transparency. They do have a right to say, hey, why hasn't the money been handed over? That is perfectly right, you know. Don't think I'm saying that, oh, Shaggy Foundation should just get all the time in the world for doing what they feel like. What I'm just saying is the way how people deal with it, the way how the media put the story out there, the way how the public interpret it, how Bustamante deal with it, it seems to me like one big miscommunication. When these two, especially the Foundation and Bustamante, should have been on the same page. When the initial story come out and Bustamante is like, well, we don't know. I'm like, how can you not know? You must be in communication. So somewhere along the line, there was a breakdown, right? So I hope people just take this as a learning lesson, right? And as I said, Shaggy, I hope you don't get too turned off by the situation and continue to do what we are doing. I mean, this is great PR. Remember, you know, people, Shaggy literally brand this thing with his own name, you know, right? So, the PR of helping the Bustamante hospital originally was excellent for Shaggy's brand and Shaggy's image. So now when the whole money gone missing because a theme name attached to it, again, it was hurting his brand and his image, right? So it might turn him off and make him stop this concert. But we're going to see. Right. So Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.